to satisfy several subs requests, let's play 7 matches with Luke using 201, 202 and 203 cards plus nylon string in the 204 of Tennis Clash, a sports game published by White Live Studios. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel Go and Play 365 if you like this video. So you are seeing here the build that I'm using with Luke for the 7 matches. So even when I am using only normal cards composed with 201, 202 and 203 cards, that gives this those stats once I enter the 204 with the capping at level 9. Well, even when I'm using only those normal cards, you're going to see that in all matches I still have more total power than my opponents. The matches are then unbalanced, and that's a pity for the show, but I can't do otherwise because the game didn't propose any opponent having better total power, and I can't lower the levels of my cards even if I wanted to. So I start the series of matches with a match versus Chona using the Maestro Monty. So using the special string, it's going to counterbalance a bit the power, the ratio of power between the two characters. My opponent is going to have a slight advantage thanks to this surplus of stamina, but of course he still has a lower total power, so it's not very fun for him. However, he's going to play very well. Second serve. Apparently, he's an experienced player in 204. Second serve. Has a quite decent serve given his serve stat, and I'm making some unforced errors. Second serve. 226 kilometers per hour serve. That's pretty fast, right? Alright. Windshield wiper mode. As you can see, my stamina bar is going down quite fast. Playing with nylon string, that's the problem, of course. I've been lucky to hit that ace there. Second serve. Yeah, my opponent was hitting very hard shots. And kept serving very well. And I return as I could, fortunately, by the end. My opponent committed some unforced errors, and I took profit of the occasion to end the match. That was hard. Nylon String versus Maestro Monty. Even versus an opponent having lower total power, but who knows how to serve fast and hit strong shots, that was not easy. Let's play versus Florence. So Luke has almost the same base stats than Victoria. He's just a bit more agile, but has a bit less stamina, a very slightly weaker volley. That doesn't matter much, by the way, because they don't play serve and volley. The same forehand and a very slightly better backhand. Luke is right-handed, as you can see in this video, and that's the main difference with Victoria, who is left-handed. Otherwise, they are both aggressive baseliners. They have the same age, 28, and almost the same height. 1.84 meters for Luke versus 1.82 meters for Victoria. So I'm playing with the high serve to strong hands build, which I think is a good style to use in lower tours so as to keep the win ratio decent.
2.
All right, cross court drop shot, and a winner return. Another cross court winner. All right, let's open this bag. 2 or 4 bags. Some Florence cards that I haven't maxed out yet. So some subs asked me why I haven't maxed out my low and mid tours characters yet. They were a bit surprised I haven't got them at level 11 yet, like Florence, or Hope, or Jonah, etc. But well, the reason is very simple. I didn't grind enough in low tours and mid tours. You know, I went to tour 7 as fast as possible. And that was what I wanted to play in high tours. So I grinded a bit in the low tours at first when I started playing the game. Because I was playing only like 2 or 3 matches per day during the first months. Not seriously then, not for the channel. But then, well, by January, I started to play many more matches daily. And, well, when I got enough experience, I moved to mid-tours and unlocked tour 7. And then I tried to play as many matches as possible in tour 7 and unlock to 8 and play in high tours only afterwards. And you know that if you open almost exclusively tour 7 and tour 8 bags, you have a lot more of cards, possible cards from different tours in the tour 7 and tour 8 bags. You know that there are not only tour 7 cards and tour 8 cards in the tour 7 and tour 8 bags. There are cards from lower tours, lower and mid tours as well, from tour 1 to 8 actually in a tour 8 bag. Second serve. So the pool of cards is much bigger. While if you open tour 4 bags only, you will get tour 1 to tour 4 cards in those tour 4 bags. You will not get the tour 5 to 6 to 7 and to 8 cards. So you have better chance to get the cards that you want if the cards that you wanted were the ones from the tour 1 to tour 4. So yeah, by opening those tour 7 and tour 8 bags, well, I got many different cards and not so many character cards, and that took me a lot of time to level up different characters.
Second serve.
Oh right, well, in this match my opponent didn't seem to be on very good form. The serve was quite slow. I don't know if it was on purpose. Okay. What is inside? Eagle increased hydration. 2 cards that I maxed out since a long time ago. Alright. Achuna using Swallow Poly. Well, I would say that Swallow Poly is almost even worse than Nylon String, because it's it will make you deplete your stamina very fast. if you can't end rallies fast enough, thanks to the critical shot that it offers. But generally, in lower tours, like 201 to 204, well, I guess that the power of the hand is not enough to trigger the critical often enough. So using the swallow bully only offers the long catch tier 1, I would say. But the problem is that the long catch is making you drain your stamina very fast. So yeah, instead of using the swallow pulley, well, I would simply use the nylon string. Okay, what's inside this grand bag? Nothing special. Only a chocolate quartz that could be useful versus a high serve big forehand players, but not really in 204, I guess. It's rather to use in mid and high tours. I have very rarely seen any opponent use the choker course versus me during my matches in 204. So this opponent, it's quite strong. But the same problem is here again, the use of the swallow pulley. It's not taking advantage of the critical. So he only has the long catch. The problem is, he again is going to lose stamina a lot with that long catch. Some nice hard shots. Yep, and due to his lack of stamina, his Chona couldn't reach some balls, even if he was not very far from it. And with lower stamina, well, accuracy is not very high by the end of the match. Okay, Chona having a weak backhand. I'm going to insist on this backhand. And well, my opponent knows he has to cover this backhand side most of the time. So it's easier to wrong foot him by hitting on the other side, on his forehand side. Returning on his backhand side is obviously the best thing to do when you return serve. Some cross court drop shot. Unfortunately, it was out. Yep, because he tried to cover too much his backhand side. That was not easy because he let the court very open on his forehand side. Alright, let's open this bag and you are going to see again the lineup that they use for all 7 matches with Luke. Well, I hope you enjoy watching me play with Luke in 204 with 201 to 203 cards using nylon string. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel Gameplay 365 to stay tuned for new videos of Tennis Clash. Thank you a lot for your support and see you soon on Gameplay 265. Bye-bye.